certain times, different times, what are the reasons, individual reasons, for individually, I mean, you said you named 17. What 17? Why 17? What happened at 17?
17 was training for you to learn something, some tactic that you'll need later.
A topic?
Tactic.
Tactic, very good. 18.
Eighteen was very similar to 19, except they didn't really know who you were yet, so that was just for a tour, an exploration. How do you do?
That they were introducing themselves to me.
So no, well, they were like interviewing you. That was it.
Okay. So what was the difference? Were the same group as 17 as in 18 and 19?
No, 19 is when they knew. They had confirmation from the other guy. And then, so they thought you being connected with the ones that contacted you when you were 13, that they could get information about that. So they pretty much left you alone.
And these were extraterrestrials, or this was government? Government.
High level government, though.
Say what?
High
level.
It's where you're getting. Remember, you're talking about the space program. This isn't like a bunch of white dudes hanging out in a room.
Secret space program, though, correct?
It's a lot more open of species.
Very good. So these particular species, could you describe the species from 17?
17. Well, that was actually just people.
Ah, very good. Okay.
That was something different.
And then 18 and 19? What species?
There were soldiers that looked like scaly lizard faces.
Very good. Am I connected to the draconians? Okay. Is that why I dreamed about a lot of dragons and that whole thing? At that age, I drew a bunch of pictures of them.
Something on a much higher level than what you think of when you say draconian is what I see about that experience.
Okay, but when I ask you what they look like, you said scaly skin, so that's what made me just say draconian.
Yes.
For lack of a better word. But when you say higher, what do you mean by that?
Soldiers.
Oh, okay, that's your thought, but not from my perspective, unless that's what the records are saying. How are you getting the records? Is the golden alien insect looking person? Are they giving you the information, or you're literally at the record and getting it from there?
The records is very high dimension.
Okay.
Because it records all the other dimensions, so when you get there, it becomes. It's almost like when you ask me a question, I have to give them a frame. It's not even about permission, it's about targeting.
Okay.
Even targeting.
Ah, understood. That's why this being specific is important.
Yes.
Okay.
All the data's there, but you
have to ask the right question.
Yeah. They can't find it. They just give me a big multi-dimensional hunk of stuff, and I can't say that to you.
Okay, I understand.
researched it unless we had a lot of time.
I totally understand. So I, this is being at these records are much different than interviewing someone face to face or whatever. So of course I know I need to change my style and my tactic. So I
imagine you're doing a Google search, but you just type in like.
Yes, totally understood. Okay. So after age 19, what was the next age? 21. What was going on when I was 21 years old to make extraterrestrials come in and give me a visit?
21 was a crossover between good people in the space program and a different race that was helping clean up some tie I don't know what it ties to, like cutting cords in a way that would let you spring forward a little bit.
Me as a energy entity that's focused on Earth.
Yeah, like, I mean, you're like all over the world. Do you know that?
Yeah, they say there are 57,000 of me.
Yeah, there's like a shit ton.
So what am I? Am I a collective or just one that divided itself up to have all these different experiences?
Right, because you're really much, by the time you break, you just have a real big focus on this place right now. Like, other beings have all these different parts, you know, because they're at that high dimension too, but they are invested. You're really heavily invested here for a long time.
Why am I so heavily invested on
fire? They like let you in on it really early. You really loved it, the idea of it.
Is that why I do all this stuff with my channel and?
Oh man, to be involved here, you had to do. You got involved. That's why you're so big. And that's why you're not as bright of a color. Because you're more spread out. You had to do and invest in a lot of different places all over the place. And
why?
All of the times to get it all right. To be ready to put 57,000
expressions of my.
I don't even see it as. When I look at the planet, I just see a net of this like reddish, mostly red, like orangey.
And this is my energy?
Yeah.
Spread
it's like
out
a
all
net,
over.
Like, yeah, all mm-hmm. over. Really.
In a positive way?
It's like a, not like a motherly, but like a brotherly, like.
So did I help create the topography of this planet? Is that why I'm so vested in it?
Yes. Even that question was hard because you put. You ask if you're invested, but then when I look to answer the question, I see you in the topography, so yes, you are invested. Yes, you are the topography.
So my energetic signature is the mountains and the oceans,
yeah.
And the lake.
Yeah, the mountains, I see that a lot. It's a lot of mountains. Wide open green hills.
Who is Hank? Who is Hank? What is Hank? How is he able to be all that? Is he the exact same as everyone else, or I'm sure that everything is individual, but what? When I say who is Hank, is was
you
he,
have an energy signature of like a balloon. Blowing up until they just if there were 10,000 balloons in this room, they were all filling up the room until it was just full of it. Like a expansive energy. It's like really red, a little bit orange. That's what I say.
Okay.
It's like you don't. It just like melts into the puddle.
What about Henry Jones the second?
Henry Jones the second. That's like engraved in it. That's your real name?
Henry Jones the second.
That's what's on all your records.
Mm-hmm.
Engraved on all of it. Know the bigger story. Way beyond Hank.
Exactly.
But I can't.
And you said that your signature seems like it is smaller or something to that effect?
Yeah.
What's the difference?
Not so much expanding. More like a coveting.
Was Henry Jones II created to do this type of work that he's doing, or to express himself in the way he's expressing? Was he created to do that?
Yeah. There was a whole bunch of, there was at least five major, maybe six major lines of trajectory through your record. But yeah, you picked a certain one. The healing people-centric one.
Say healing, what was the other?
People. You like to, in this one, you like to deal with people. And connect with us.
Okay.
You like, but that's like a sidestep. Anyway, what was your question?
Well, I asked you, was I created to come in and do what I'm doing on
yes.
this planet?
Yeah, as one.
So created in term, I mean, someone says...
You created.
Okay. I created myself to come on. I've been told that I've been helping lots of different civilizations throughout the universe.
Mm-hmm.
During their ascension process, and that's when I would go in and focus. Okay, is that what you see in the records? That's what I do when planets and solar systems are ascending into higher vibrations. I'm there to help that process.
Yes, but also in the various other times, the preparation, the philosophy, the even the topography, the recipe. You're involved with the recipe as much as the taste test. You're learning the whole universe is learning with you, though. How to do it. What are the possibilities?
And I created myself to do that? Prime Creator created me to do that, or how? I must be pretty old.
You expanded a lot. You covered a lot of ground. You are a surveyor. You like to take it all in and vacuum it up.
So you say to cook it and eat it?
Because you want to blow up the balloon so it touches everything.
Okay.
So you touch it, eventually you just touch it.
Ah, very good. I do test myself a lot. That's my favorite thing. Did I notice that?
No. They don't. They say they don't.
They say
they
what?
Don't read anything.
Okay. Very good. Let's just keep it. So now my older age is 51. I don't know the older age. It's 36, 51 when the extraterrestrials are coming in.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on with me and them right now?
You're being treated in a chamber.
My higher self or my physical body?
My physical body.
And that's what that is it connecting to my left ear where the devices or the energetic is coming into me? How are they treating me in the chamber?
What are they doing?
How or what are they doing?
They're using the chamber as a light concentrator, which is related to tangentially to information that you receive. Is totally different.
Okay.
It's not for, it's like connecting like a wire between continents for the internet. It's a deep connection. So that you're becoming through experience. Training, like exercise.
Okay.
And the forces it. You know, it's very strong. It takes you there.
Takes me where?
To connect and stay with the higher soul.
Oh, very good. Am I on a mission this time?
You're always on a mission.
Always, every time I come in, mm-hmm. Every time I take a physical incarnation, I'm on a mission.
And your mission is take in as much as you can.
Take in as much as I can.
Yeah. That's always your mission. You're trying to put it all together. That's why you're on all these councils. You're trying to put it all together. All these different threads. Yeah.
Big tapestry.
Yeah, but more like think of it as like the perfect meal, the perfect soup.
Ah, very good. Okay.
Oh, you find the spice from India, you find the spice from Italy, you find the right combination.
And how
you gotta go find all these places. But it's like you gotta be in it, so that's why you're always putting yourself on these low vibrational experiences to really
get the gist,
not in a philosophical way.
Okay.
It says that you tried.
So I've tried with philosophy, but coming to the earth.
Only philosophy.
And only, I've tried in the past only with philosophy, but this time I'm coming in to actually experience it.
Yeah.
To back it up.
That's what this universe is about.
The physical universe has us to experience everything that it already knows.
No, that's the theme of this one.
Okay.
You really like it.
How many universes have I been in?
What I just saw was three. What the bigger part of you that thought they could do it through philosophy and then came here to that's just the one. Then it's a much bigger game outside of that bubble.
Oh, okay. So in this particular universe, in this particular physical universe, did they see in the records, can you see me ascending in this physical body? If you look forward, can you see me ascending in this physical body?
I was watching that you were much happier having put your foot in the pool. That you could really, really learn. And that you did learn and that you are loving that. That's what the big, deep, underwater part of pride earlier, that's what that really was.
Okay, go ahead. So I've been philosophizing everything, and
yeah.
Once I came to the physical universe and I actually physically manifest, it I liked it.
Much better. You didn't think you would like it, that's why you never did it. But this universe loved it. And everybody's really liking it. Through the whole multiverse, they like it.
Being able to physically manifest.
I can't be there for very long.
Oh, don't you start that business now. Can't be where?
At the multiverse.
Why not? Too much for you to handle?
Yeah, I used to.
Cool.
I don't go this far out.
Tank that far out.
Yeah.
Let's reel you back in, back to the Akasic. Back to the Akasic.
Okay.
It's almost, I'm not gonna say special, but a really interesting character that Henry Jones II.
Henry Jones II.
Very good. So let's go to your records and maybe how.
Changed the whole place though, that's more woody and more.
These people you know?
They're terrific. I feel like that place where the mice live, actually.
The mice?
Yeah.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, it feels like the smell of it, and the, but not the really the look of it. Just the.
Librarian, what is the name of that race? If there is a name,
from last one, it was the place. The place is their name. PLUT. NARES.
Oh, very good.
This is really.
How old did you live to be in that life? Like in those lives?
That one was really old.
That's not good. That's not a number.
I was in 200. No. 52. 5236.7.
Okay. And you were still fairly young, huh?
No.
Oh, you were wrinkled. I remember you were old.
Yeah, wrinkly and balding and like a mess.
Highly evolved?
Well, just really in touch with nature.
Very gay.
It's a real happy place, actually.
Is it a planet, or is it here on the Earth, in another dimension, or subject. How many is? Were you there before you came here to the Earth, or until you got start focusing on the Earth?
No, it's just my favorite place.
Oh, very good. What's going? What
What's it's like? Oh, that's why I like nooks and crannies. That's why I like darkness.
Is this what the places that you lived? What it was like there?
It's like being really small, living on a jungle floor. It's just really dark. And
but you have clothes, though.
Yeah.
Did you have clothes on just because it would have felt weird being naked?
No.
You actually had clothes on.
That's what I wore.
What was the purpose of that life for you? What does the record say? After you left there, when you died there, or when you decided to no longer focus there, where did you go to?
A second incarnation in this universe. That was my first one.
Oh, very nice.
My second one was...
People.
Motion around in the water.
People?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, people. Yeah, those people.
What time frame could you tell? Or what planet was it on?
X-E-N-A-R-E-S.
Ah, oh, very good. And what did you look like then? Let me show you an image of what you look like.
I'm kind of long brown hair. I got a lot of hair. That kind of wavy. Yeah.
Long wavy hair?
Yeah, kind of. Not. It didn't really look like humans too much. Like. Slumped over and
look at your appendages and what does that look like? Your limbs.
Like not much hair, a lot of moles and the limbs are just kind of
any fingers or anything like that?
Yeah, like, yeah. Looks ridiculous.
Not human.
The fingers, yeah, they're kind of insectoid slash. And they just look scaly. They're so wrinkled and short fingered and...
How do you communicate? How did you communicate?
A lot of clicking noises. I think I'm an insect, actually. No.
Intelligent?
Something before insects.
Well, but you're not on the planet Earth, are you?
No.
So, as an extraterrestrial, you know, you may be anything. And I say terrestrial for a better, like, better word. Very good. And how long did you live in that life? What was the lifespan of that type of entity? Does that in records?
What was the lifespan?
What made you, what was your decision to manifest in that particular type of physical body? Is it in the record?
Yeah. Experience more. Well, it's different, right? It was on the water. It was much bigger. I'm just learning about the basics.
Human, or not human life, but just physical life.
Okay. Yeah. Life. Wasn't this fun? It was more adventurous. It wasn't this happy, it was more tragic. As far as learning, just in general, there was a lot of lives.
How many physical lives have you taken in? How many physical, how many lives, incarnations have you taken in the physical universe?
A million?
A million?
626. But you had like four zeros.
I thought you said I only came into this physical universe three times.
No. This is your third universe of this multiverse.
Oh, the third
major
theme. Oh, a third major theme in this multiverse.
Yes. Multi.
So I've had many themes for coming in. Okay, so that sort of makes sense. I asked, and we had a session last week, or 2 weeks ago, maybe three, how many times. I was told by Nate that I had been here three times. One time didn't count. And but then when they broke it down, so does that, do you mean three whole themes and one time didn't count?
One time was like, it feels like you didn't learn anything, but you learned like some default matrix of how this, it was like an introduction skeleton outline of this multiverse.
So it didn't count.
It feels pretty hollow.
Okay, so, and when they say, I mean, this is really interesting material that you're saying. When they say the third time, so within the third major theme, how many different lifetimes say just in one of those themes?
This one's like.
This one, yeah, that I'm in now.
This universe is in the like six zeros higher than mine. Like, what is that? A billion, trillion, a quadrillion? It seems like.
So I've been all over this universe then.
This one, you like this one. The last one was like 1,000. 1,746.
And then before, then the first time that I decided to come into a physical incarnation into the multiverse.
One time. Or zero times.
So how could it be three? Three themes.
Three themes.
This one, you say.
Each.
See, I'm sorry, say it again.
Each universe has a theme.
Okay.
Has a song, has a.
You said a song?
Vibration is just too meager.
You said song, didn't you?
Song. A song, like, okay. I like song because it's could be beautiful, it could be the confidence, it could be, but it's an experience.
Okay.
And it enforces that basis, that one default note, which is the theme, but it's a song. It's all these things. It's just another fractal.
So what was the first one then?
First one was just default matrix of how this multiverse works.
Okay, and then there, that one didn't that count, the, and then there were three others, is that correct?
No.
No, that was one of the themes.
One, two, three. Two, the second theme was working without descending. Philosophy without.
Oh my god, very good. I understand that. And then the third one, being here where I am now.
It's clothes, it's fashion, it's fun, you like it. You really like it.
So, where before?
You might be like, this universe is, you gotta be like the number one fan or something. Like you.
That's why you see me as those balloons just growing and growing.
No, yeah, this place is full of that.
So that's the third, okay.
People are like, you know, it's like Houston. People move here, they expand out further. People move in more, they expand out further. The differences between inner Houston and outer Houston become more diverse. That's like this universe. People just keep moving here just because they like the laws of it, the rules of it.
Okay, and so back to you then. What are you doing here?
Who's that?
What are you doing here?
I'm having a session.
No, I mean in this, this theme. What theme were you in?
Learning about
how to create.
I'm learning about the laws of it. I'm learning about it in a more philosophical or heady kind of learning about it to write a song, to write that universe. Yeah.
So
that's why I like programming a lot, because I'm creating these places.
So are you training now?
Yeah. I just like to program. I'm just so interested in how to program. Not so much live it, but live it enough to learn patterns.
What are you going to do with that information, all this experience that you're having?
I made all kinds of universes, man.
You already been making them?
Yeah. Thousands.
What brought you into this particular universe now?
Popular.
Oh, it's so popular, huh?
Yeah.
Where were you and I before we, Hank and, where were we and James before we decided to come to the physical themed universes? What does the record show?
It's too big.
Connected to source? Connects to Prime Creator.
Whatever you did, just grounded it.
Very good. And you're still, your tailbone is still wrapped around the core of the Earth. And in Inhale that violet flame. Raise your vibration, and equalize your. We're back at the Hall of Records. Didn't need to get you out there so far, but obviously you're able to go, which is a good thing, but I know it's going to be a little disconcerting. With every breath you take, you're becoming more grounded and more focused in the Akashic Records. When you look in your records, what do you see in your next 4 years on the planet Earth? What do you see happening about that's going to happen and not really hurt you or change you in any way by knowing in advance?
4 years.
4 years.
Mm-hmm.
4 years into the forever moment of now.
World changes. World.
I see you smiling. How does the world change?
Oh, it just gets better in every way you can think of. That's the best I can.
What's the best thing that you can foresee? In terms of
peace, prosperity, just change
for the entire planet.
Yeah, and change.
You see any war going on?
War.
4 years on the planet?
No.
Or is that all just
killing.
Faded.
Yeah, faded. Like it's just the beginnings of it, though.
What about the political scene? How does that feel?
Stupid.
They're still stupid in 4 years. But there's much more peace, though.
Yeah.
So
yeah, they have to play the game.
Different people have stepped in the power, positions of power.
Yeah.
Where do you see Hank in 4 years?
4 years from now?
Yeah, look at his record.
He's a diner.
A diner?
Yeah.
He's at a diner?
Yeah, he's in bed.
What's it
different? You're really happy.
Am I eating?
Yeah. But you're doing more talking. You're just holding some thing that you would eat. But you're talking. You're talking about these days. You're just laughing, and they're laughing.
What am I talking to?
The person, the server.
No.
The server and the people at the bar. At the diner. You said at the diner on a stool. And it's really clean. It's like real shiny.
There's a group of people you say that are there listening, or everyone's just eating and going about their daily life?
They're just talking about daily stuff. Yeah.
Okay.
They're not. They just.
Chop my hair off?
No. No.
It's pretty long.
Yeah,
now.
You got pretty long hair. Yeah. But you're like really in shape.
Yeah, I just started this program.
When you're like a biker shape. You're on the go.
Awesome. Where do you see yourself in those 4 years? Look at the
that
records.
4 years?
Yeah. You said you'd be really happy.
4 years of some dark room, scribbling something. I keep practicing creation.
So are you focused totally in physicality, or are you focused on?
I think I'm working the same job, actually.
Awesome.
Working at the same place for you.
We like it.
It's a little bit exhausting, actually. I'm not as happy as you. I'm being a good Leo.
But you're doing good work, though, right?
Mm-hmm. Doing really good work.
Well, it just probably seems like I'm happy. Did I feel happy?
Yeah. You were so energized, man. I was like, night, and you were like, sun rising.
I wonder what that difference is. What does the record show? We have different missions, though.
Yes. Different voluntary interests. Mission.
Or focus. So, I say mission, I know it's the wrong word. It's a decision. Yeah, we decide, okay, I'm going to come and do this. And you decide you're going to come and do that. It's all voluntary.
But you couldn't make us not do it. That would be like, no. We are.
Yeah. What, you say you were at the same job. Where was I at?
It's like a mission you can't fail. What job were you? You didn't have a job.
Was that a job? Well, you said I was talking to people and eating a sandwich or something.
I feel like. Was I came across the continent or something? You're doing some kind of traveling.
Okay.
And you're.
I do love to travel. Can't imagine. What type of vehicles are happening in 4 years? Can you see those? Move to the records. What is the transportation? What is that like? Mm-hmm. What type of technology?
Yeah, kind of. It looks the same, but just different technology. So it's like a car, but it's like
still using gas, or is the energy source changed? 4 years has totally changed, Tom.
Somewhat changed.
I have a friend.
It's like a conversion of something that was already.
My friend Cameron. Said after his QHHT session, he's been going back, he's been shifting into the future, and he said in 2020, he said he went in 4 years, and there were Tesla cars, and that there were kiosks where you can go in and get your energy. Can you see that as well? Mm-hmm. What is that all about, the kiosk where you can go in and get your energy signature enhanced? What type of technology does the records show for that?
Power, just it's not even your car, it's just like a.
Oh no, I'm sorry. He was talking about the Tesla cars. He said that were really big. And then he also said at the malls there were these things like kiosks, okay, where you can go in and get a stand in stuff like. Remember you said I was in a chamber?
Chamber on a ship, and in 4 years,
I'm on a chamber in a ship in 4 years.
No.
Okay, I'm sorry, I get that much now.
Be incorrect to call them this one that you're.
You say a loner?
Like a loner car.
And I'm driving it?
You like using it to travel.
Okay. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Other people have them as well.
That is a probability, though.
Ah, very good.
Because it could happen in a bunch of different years.
But it could happen in four easily, huh?
Could. But we're gonna go as slow as we can to make sure that we bring as many as we can to me.
Of the collective.
But in a but in a let's see what everybody has learned kind of way. That's where you're so instrumental.
Spread the word that we're more than what we think we are.
Yeah, as well as like the way that you do sessions. Like how you always do sessions and you make it your own kind of way. You collect up all these ways and then you turn into a soup and then you.
The soup that we're doing now is, I think it's getting better and better. I like the way you pushed me back into my chair and made me ground. Because I was getting frustrated. Now look how smoothly you're speaking.
I had to connect with you.
How very cute.
So that I can flip somewhere else.
Seem to take you in really distant places and gets uncomfortable sometimes. But it's meant for you to.
It's almost unspeakable. It's just.
But you're grounded and you're safe and you're protected. And it's very, very good. Very good. I think we've gotten a lot out of those records. We could probably come back and connect with those later, huh? What about that entity that was sort of golden, that looks sort of like an insect? Is he the librarian?
Yes.
He's still there?
Yes.
What does the other look like?
Same. Somewhat the same.
It's just
metallic and gold and nonsensical shapes, geometry.
You overhear Corey Good talk about the one that had an upside down triangle head?
No, not that one.
Have you heard of that one though?
Yeah.
So when you say geometrical shapes, does it put you in the mind of that one? Because you
that
said
that one's
they were
really big.
Is he there?
Yeah.
What are they doing there?
They don't say much. They sit watching.
So how many people are sitting around watching our session? Are we in that amphitheater?
Yeah.
So we are, huh? They like to. What are they there for?
Some of them are like at a ball game, and some of them are like at a medical class. And some of them are just watching a movie.
Very good. Who are they coming? They're coming to pay attention to what Henry Jones II and James is doing now. They're learning from us, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
And we knew that did we know that we would come in and do these things, and that they would be there to come and watch?
Oh, we're in there. We're in the stand, too.
Ah, very good. So can you see my Augustine and Isabel there?
Yes.
What do they look like?
Augustine's really big. But yeah, he's bigger than the whole stadium.
Yeah, I sort of figured, I heard.
But you and the
Isabel.
Feminine one, yeah.
Yeah.
Isabel. Y'all just sitting in the stadium with these bleachers.
What do I look like over there?
Like, I don't know. Kind of with a, like a green, a white, and like a black, a white. You look kind of like a bird in the face. Like it's all slipped to the, it's all like.
But you know it's me, huh?
Yeah.
Can't even describe it, huh? And I'm sitting next to Isabel, and so.
But if I look at Isabel, she's different. Just like you were different before I looked at you. Because it's. This place is.
Amazing, huh?
It'll change what you're looking at to fit. If I'm connected to you, then I know what you're trying to say. I see that.
Oh, okay. So if you sort of can feel what I'm thinking, and then, or feel what I'm feeling, and then you look and you see how you interpret it. Is that it?
Yeah. When I go to look at you, you're like this trail, like a blur of energy. But when I don't, when I just see like you and Isabel and Augustine, you know, just far away and like normal looking. You and Isabel are just like people. Augustine's just a big reddish, slightly orange color. Big.
And then what about Rottier with the triangle hat? What does he look like? How?
Rottier is an avian.
Oh, he's an avian.
He's not there, but I saw him in my head.
Oh, okay. And you said he's an avian, huh?
Yeah.
What about the triangle head? The one with the upside down triangle head? Ooh, what is that?
It's just the way that they chose to look for some reason.
Okay. And what about you?
It means something.
Oh, it means something.
Yeah. It means something. I think it's like in homage to this universe, where a triangle that points down and go down or descend.
All that big energy is not focused on its point, going down into the bottom of the pyramid, into the third dimension, or into physicality.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Interesting. Very interesting. And what do you look like sitting in the stands?
Oh, we're in the talk show. In the middle of it. Like little tiny.
Oh, that's us in the middle. But you said you could see me sitting in the stand with Isabel. Do you see yourself, your higher self, sitting out there as well?
Mm-hmm.
What do you look like?
Well, my higher self is there. But my future self was there too.
Oh, awesome.
It was learning something.
Because it's all happening in the forever moment of now, simultaneously. Would that be correct?
For reference.
Okay. Yes, for reference, for sure. So what about
myself is pretty big.
Awesome.
A big bluish, whitish translucent.
Oh, beautiful. Very beautiful to look at.
Yeah, kind of. Undulating, it doesn't really have like an outline.
Okay, just an undulating energetic sequence. Very beautiful. Sananda, or Sananda there.
Sananda. It's not there.
Not there? What about Ashtar?
Ashtar. A part of Ashtar. It's there. A lower Blackie.
A Blackie?
Blackie.
Oh, a Blackie. And what is Ashtar's lackey doing? What they're there to observe to, or I'm sorry. Could you address them?
Actually, they're communicating with you.
Ah, they're communicating with me.
Yeah, they're sending you that downstream.
I was told in a session a couple days ago that I was Ashtar, which I thought was like one of the, like, I don't know how I thought. I just was like sort of blown away by that, because I know there's a gentleman view of this moment who says that he's Commander Ashtar, and so I'm sure Ashtar could have maybe probably many incarnations. But how is that? Was that a mistake, or they're just basically saying I'm connected to that? Since you said that their lackey was speaking to you,
yeah,
just connected to it.
Yeah, but. Connected means you're part of it, they're not wrong. They're just saying the tip of the iceberg. They're just saying they're just
what
saying
is
what they see.
So this lackey is in the stadium and he's communicating with me, and you said that's that stream of energy. So that means I'm a part of that galactic fleet then? Or there's an expression of myself that's a part of the galactic fleet? Was that one of the councils that I sit on?
There's like a part of you at every level of that organization.
There's a part of me at every level of that organization?
Yeah. Like imagine if I was saying, if you looked at an anthill and you only saw the cavities.
Oh, okay. I'm everywhere, huh?
Yeah, he's doing a bunch of shit there.
Do they call that the Ashtar Command? That's what I've heard. The organization is called the Ashtar Command. All the people.
That's what they say.
Are they on a biosphere or on some type of ship? That Ashtar Command or.
Bunch of that. They have ships, yeah.
Can you see them?
Yeah, they look white. They look white a lot. And blue. That's what the guy's wearing, is a bunch of white.
They call him Commander Ashtar. Is he, is the, Sananda is supposed to be the commander, I don't know if he's the commander, I don't know what Sananda would be, but I guess the highest ranking general, if we were, for lack of a better word, but.
He has the highest influence.
Sananda has the highest influence.
Yeah. More connections than you. You actually look very small compared to his involvement.
And
what are you calling Ashtar?
Okay, so, and when I say Ashtar, when I say Ashtar Command, they say Sananda is the top guy, correct?
Yes.
And then, as far as I'm concerned, well, I'm here on the planet, but I'm not Ashtar himself.
Oh, I see Ashtar now.
Okay, very good. Very, very good.
He's an energy too. Like, very much purple-ish, brownish, kind of.
And what's our do this
and
energy?
He's like pouring out this
beautiful
energy onto Earth. Like a room.
Like a what?
Like a donut that has icing being put on it. Like a,
okay.
A layer of just coating it with this
unconditional love?
Yeah. In his way, like this real smooth chocolatey kind of. It's real sweet.
Something good, right?
That's his theory on how to do it.
Okay, very good. And then, do you have a connection with Ashtar?
No.
Does Hank have a connection with Ashtar?
Yes.
And what would that connection be?
You have a bunch of incarnations doing various deeds in that organization.
Oh, okay.
Have the experience of doing that portion. You put yourselves in all the different portions. Not necessarily that you have an opinion, but more like you want to make sure that you survey everything. Very thoroughly, but not like Zananda with Ashtar. Not that kind of, just pervasively, you know.
Myself pervasively?
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of spaces between you, but there's just a lot of.
How am I able to do that?
Well, for one, the biggest reason is that you live like it. Technically, how you do it is the way that anybody in.
Now you're in the movie now yourself. Do you like being in this movie?
Not like you do. In a different way.
But look at you now. You're here, third dimensionally, physically focused, but at the same time, you're being multidimensional at the same time.
Yeah.
And which has always been, but normally, you know, we know everything's happening simultaneously, but normally you're not focused the way you are now. How's your body doing?
It's okay, a little tired.
Okay. Well, I think we've gotten as much out of the scene as we possibly can. We may come back later. There's a beautiful entity, your higher self needs to come over and give you a message. So let your higher self come on over, and as they get closer to you, everyone else in the background starts to fade. You feel your vibration totally.
Right.
Yes. Go ahead and receive it.
Closing.
Records are closed by your guardian angel, your guide, your higher self.
Yes.
They're still there. The one who's needed with Isabel will always be there. And let's thank the gentleman, or I'm sorry, the entities, we'll say the golden entities. And it looks sort of like insects. Them and thank them for their amazing service. And next time when we come, we'll have more specific questions for her.
We created them.
Oh, very good. Excellent.
Yeah.
very thankful for them. Your higher self. And I know my higher self is there. They're not going to leave. They'll be here for the duration.
The way my higher self and your higher self treat each other is like brothers. Your brother on the shoulder.
Oh, very good. We have things in common. Even if our focus and our what we chose to come here for has been different, but at the same time, our paths have crossed, and it's a very good thing. It's part of both of our training, so to speak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how it sounds says. Don't worry so much about the abductions. That will all make more sense in the future. In the next 10 years. Don't worry about it.
I haven't really worried about it. And unless my energy signature is giving off worry, I'm just really curious because I never got that much information about that before, and I just wonder why they were keeping it from me.
Because you're keeping it from him.
Okay. Very good. That's understood. Trust that. Thank you for just relinquishing or allowing that much to come through. I was just surprised when the door was open the last time and that came out. But it makes much more sense. Does that make sense? Can you feel what I mean? By this?
Honestly, it says I was looking more tired.
I was talking about the, not with you, but with someone else.
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Now, your higher self, I want you to just go ahead and listen to this beautiful message that they have for you. I can almost hear it already. You can share it if you will. Yellow.
Message is like a big yellow light.
That's your solar plexus energy. That's the energy that feeds your entire being.
Play more. This was just
play more, very good.
Play more. Mm-hmm. It was this really nice blue from my higher self.
And I want you to ask your higher self.
And that's something about my theme. And when I find out, the more that I become myself, playing, programming is playing.
Very good. Can you ask your higher self to send some unconditional light to your throat? And then to your hyoid and thyroid and that entire area on your body. And when they send that light, can you tell me what color it is? It's coming in. that's been pulled away from it, or is that the light that's coming toward it?
Spoken out before and it got me killed.
You'd spoken out before and it had gotten you killed, and this is another lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
In which, what did you speak out about the nature of reality?
Corruption.
Corruption. What is on, was it on earth?
Yeah.
Previous lifetime. Is that,
I was trying to meet a different timeline. It was worth it.
It was worth that?
Yeah.
So this is the information your higher self has given you as they're working on you? Are they still working on you? Receive. And only receive it if it is the highest vibration of unconditional love. You accept nothing but love, nothing that would harm you in any way, nothing that would manipulate you in any way, nothing that would lead you down the wrong path in any way.
This one's supposed to tell me that I can sustain myself.
Been receiving downloads of late, haven't you?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know the nature of your downloads? Without giving anything away?
Like, grace. Just dealing with realization of the influence I'm having on my own reality. Like that. Like if you're looking in the mirror and you are gradually turning the light up, first you just see just a fraction, just the outline.
The light is getting brighter for you, isn't it? And you're starting to see more of yourself, aren't you? Very good. Is that good?
It's more of myself.
Are you? You gonna allow yourself to enjoy this place as much as Hank does? Henry Jones the second.
I enjoy it. I enjoy it in a different way. But I enjoy it. My favorite thing is breaking the rule. Cause I like. For programming the theme of life.
Do you think you're breaking the rules right now?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm breaking the rules.
That's why you're doing this then? Because in a yeah. sense it feels like...
Because it doesn't fit into my head. But it still works. It's a different way.
Dolores Cannon said the energy that's coming at you during one of these sessions stays with you much longer, and it really helps you spiritually in terms of raising one's vibration to accept the energy that are bombarding the planet at this time. Would that be accurate?
Yeah. She was really helping us keep our schedules by bringing in a certain kind of light at a certain time, very bravely.
The light is information, is it not?
Yeah, it's a light on the face is information. It's not the information that's important, but the reflection of it off of the subject. Like a different way of seeing something is like a light.
Exactly. So this technique, when it allows you to be third dimensional and tap into...
Yeah, it made things concrete for some people that experienced it. And it also changed the collective to turn more towards channeling as a thing, conduit to, it's the beginning, it's like chapter one of telepathy and higher self communication and multiple space time interactions.
Communication.
Connection, and she at that time. Now, right now, this is still helping as a wave that's cresting, and other things have joined the wave. The wave invites more waves, and therefore it
sends out a bigger ripple.
Blows up, implodes, it's self-reacting, self-organizing.
Awesome.
It keeps bouncing off of itself. It's getting more energy.
So doing these types of sessions and other people seeing these types of sessions and other people learning how to do these types of sessions and ain't teaching people how to do it for free, something similar to these sessions.
Once a man healed James, artistic at a level of 15 minutes.
Amazing.
Makes beliefs have solid ground where they wouldn't before.
Did James realize the healing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Changed everything, huh?
It changed our trajectory.
What's the light doing on your throat? Will it continue to work after we're finished here?
Yes. In a way, they're done.
I'll say you're okay. We'd like to thank them.
James likes to keep things. You're not supposed to keep things.
What kind of things is James keeping that he should be relinquishing or sharing?
Different pain. Like a piercing. Like a person having a piercing.
Is this a part of his decision, or is this something that he's working to get?
He thinks he can do that. He thinks that he can. He's testing it.
Is it serving him, or is it no longer serving him?
Serving him in the sense of a horse needing to be whipped harder.
horse make that in the crack of the whip help make the horse run faster?
It should. Unless you really want to test it.
Is it making the same decisions over and over and still getting the same results?
No. Hold on to anything. He's in a different category of trajectories.
Does this type of session help him? If he decides to go back and listen?
Not in the way that you think he would.
Desire for you to share is any way that it would without me having to. No one can hear my thoughts but you.
He benefits from it because it's different. He benefits from it because it sort of puts him in a different level, layer, in a different way. It puts, challenges him.
My only thought and desire and intent is what is in his best interest, you know. When he added, he was excited about doing it, so I have no expectation.
He went with it more than was excited about it. He was excited for the opportunity to spontaneously arisen one day and the adventure of it.
That sounds pretty cool to me.
That's just what he, that's what he gets out
of. Very cute.
And he likes Hank. He thinks Hank is
well. I think, you already know what I'm up to. I'm just trying to wake up as many people as possible.
Yeah, I forgot to tell you that Augustine was saying, ring that bell.
So he likes me ringing the bell.
Ringing the bell. Yeah, because it helps other people to survey things like he surveys them. That's his favorite thing to do.
So am I surveying, the questions, say that I ask, does he like the questions that I ask when I get to the right question? Or is he channeling these questions through me? I mean, because
not in the way you're thinking about it.
Okay.
But in one way. Because he's you.
I know. I understand that. And
but he doesn't. There's a difference. There's a difference in pattern between. Or the one above Augustine.
Who's the one above Augustine? I know there is, but
the one that you all three come from.
Henry, Augustine, Isabel, we all manifest from. I said source or prime creator.
There's lower layers between.
Okay.
But it's all very much like Augustine, but Augustine is more of a personality.
So he likes the questions, because it's to, is it my interpretation of ringing the bell, or is that what he calls by ringing the bell?
This is. He likes when it's the videos, is it? And written works.
Okay.
What's all the music that you sent to him? Ring the bell. The bell is the sound of that message.
Ah, very good. The bell is a sound, but not a message. What's the interpretation of ring the bell? And now I have to ask. I thought it was me having these sessions and taping it and letting people hear.
Yeah.
But is that it, the bell?
Alright. Putting yourself out there exposes others to your energy. That's the bell.
Ah, very good.
That makes specific. In every video, in every interaction that you have, is the symbol of the sound gets interpreted, but it's always the same. But you can interpret it. When the people are exposed to it, they interpret it. It's a symbol. And then they change from it. That's the signature.
Please tell me it has a lot of love in it, or unconditional love in it.
Yeah. It's you expressing yourself to the world. Like, you hear the sound back, reverberated back to you, back amongst yourselves, and also out there. It's for everyone. Of course, it's unconditional.
Understood. Well, the only thing is Augustine for chiming in, and Isabel is always by my side. I know he's in Augustine's as well. Next time we're in this deep, so we're gonna pull James out right now. I think his body is ready to come out. We'll have to get back to find out who our higher self is, all three of us, who our higher self is, and that energy that's feeding the grid on the planet. And there's so many new things that came out. We're very appreciative speaking about the themes and really clarifying that for me. Three themes and one that didn't count, so to speak. I really appreciate that. James, I hope this has been, we've been going back and forth. James, he said we were both there in the records and we were appreciative for the records. Now I'd like James to float away and say farewell to his higher self. And say farewell to Augustine and Isabel and anyone else in the stadium who's been there watching. We only bring them forward as a curiosity to learn from, a way to, that could help us in this lifetime. But we understand that they belong in the forever moment of now, and we leave them there to continue on their journey, on their path in the forever moment of now. And we focus back here in the third dimension on here, because this is the life that we're living in. It is the most important life of all. I'm asking the subconscious to proceed to where it belongs. Which much love and thanks for that open information that's been given James tonight. I know he's really going to appreciate it. And all the other entities that we're speaking to also receive to where they belong. But as James listens to the recording and goes over the material, puts it into place, will not bother him in any way, mentally or physically. That is very important. It will not bother him in any way, mentally or physically. In a few moments, when you come fully back into body consciousness, you're going to adjust internally in whatever way is needed to allow for the realignment of all aspects of yourself, your multidimensional selves. And as you do this, you're going to become increasingly aware of a wonderful sense of balance and equilibrium at a very deep cellular level of awareness. Your body delights in this new inner balance and will continue this adjusting in the most comfortable and easy ways that you increasingly feel better and better, moment by moment. And as you breathe deeply now, you aid the body with this new self-assuredness, and all of your internal systems and organs adjust in a new way to bring you the most positive sense of well-being. And this feels terrific. This now incorporates a natural and pleasant unity with your inner and outer feelings, and day by day, you feel more refreshed and in great spirits. In fact, you feel terrific. Tonight you will sleep deeply and peacefully, and your body will continue making any adjustments needed at all levels of your being, so that you have no need to be aware of how this transpires, allowing you a greater sense of increasing well-being and inner joy. These suggestions become deeply embedded and remain with you long after you leave me today, and they will continue to help make the changes that you wish to make. Now, I want all the consciousness and personality of James to once again return and fully integrate back into this body completely. Now, all the consciousness and personality of James is once again fully integrated back into this body, replacing all the other parts we were speaking to. Now, I want James to move up, up, up through time and space, and orient yourself back into the present day and time. This is March 25th. You are lying on a recliner at Hank's place, and you just had a very interesting experience. And I want you to remember that the present life you are living now is the most important life of all, because it is the one you are focused on at the present time. And any information we find in this way is valuable, but it will not bother you in any way, mentally or physically. And as you understand it and put it in a place that is very important, it will not bother you in any way. And now, on the count of 10, how do you feel?
Exactly. I love my job.
You know why you love your job?
I do. I really understand it right now.
Oh, very good. Compared to why this crazy job that I have doing this kind of stuff, huh? awesomeness. So go ahead and put that towards you. Back towards you. There you go, right there. Okay. And so, how long did it seem like it took?
2.5 hours?
There we go. So, is that what you're looking at? Wait, see a clock somewhere?
Huh?
Oh, okay. So it felt like the whole time that it... Awesome.
You're right, it was.
Well, 2 hours, 19 minutes, 36, 37, 38, 39 seconds.
Yeah.
And, yeah, what did I say? 19 plus the 15 minutes it took me to get you under. I always like to, who cares, I just like to go longer. I like to really make sure.
With your left hand?
You're really warm.
What else do you feel? Look right there.
Feels like it's beaming. How's it feel to you?
Feels like a suntan from the inside.
Really feel pretty warm. If vibrating.
It feels like really dry.
Your body. Your body was, what do you remember?
Miles, being Miles again. And this crazy sailor that put, a big hat. And Akashic Records. Man, there's actually like really simple patterns of these colors of your higher self, my higher self, and just like, you know, like a, almost like a ghost, you would say,
mm-hmm.
without features though.
Yes.
No features, but like generally a kind of point at the top or like a, you know, but otherwise it could change into all these other. I remember that. I remember explaining to you what it looked like with Ashtar. You're born with Ashtar.
That was the first time I ever heard that before. Like, on the last session, someone's like.
That won't tell you anything, though. Because you're like, very spread out. Different aspects of this universe.
Well, it was really funny because I told someone, I was like, I'm famous on the other side, everybody knows me.
Yeah, right.
And I don't know who it was, and I don't know why I said it. I don't know who it was. I think it was someone who was going to do a session. I said, well, dude, I'm going to tell you right now, when you get there, everybody fucking knows me. For some reason, they just know me. And, you know, which I think is. Oh, it's really interesting or whatever, but it's not an ego thing for me. It's more like everyone keeps saying it, you know, so.
And don't take this negatively, because it's not a negative thing at all.
Oh, no, I don't.
It's just the one way that it's like, imagine if every room you went into, right, every room, every place, everywhere you went, in the middle of that experience, a guy across your path. He looks the same every time. He's got the same outfit on. He's writing a bunch of shit down. And that guy appeared everywhere. It's like, what? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of like what you're doing. And just like saying that guy. But I don't mean it in like any kind of rote kind of way. But that's kind of like. How I saw that you, that other people were seeing you, that you knew a lot of shit, though, you know, because you have experienced all these different places and times and ways to do this, so, which makes a lot of sense when you think about people talking about you being on a council and advising and stuff like that, being involved with that stuff. That's just, you know, the cook of the universe. Going to all these different places around the globe.
I think it's good. I mean, I think it's good if the food is good, you know what I'm saying? Right. You know, it's good stuff, you know? So, I mean, I haven't heard any. Well, I did have my nephew. He says, when you came to our planet, you took over. You were some whatever, and I took over.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and that was the first time I ever heard that. I was like, what did I do? I was like, oh, yikes. I said I took over. It was my nephew. He was real adamant about it, you know? And I was like, and so I remember in another session, I asked him, I was like, was I ever a murderer or anything like that since I've been on the planet? Because they finally said, well, you did manifest 14 times. But it's really interesting because Nate said that I had been here 3 times. So when you said 3 times, but you said it in a way to where you understood it more than whoever else had said it before, because you said, this is your 3rd theme. And I was like, oh, okay. And the 1 time didn't count because it was like, okay, like I created it.
It's like this is how
I decided to go and do it. Yes.
You know,
let's just go and do a trial run and see how it goes.
Yeah, it's not really.
And then
what you're really going to do with the computer.
Yes, and what I was doing before was trying to interpret it in a way that I could explain it. So I'm like, well, my mom had a miscarriage, and, And it's so funny when I that's why it sort of makes me laugh when they're laughing at me, because they're like, oh my god, you really have forgotten everything. But you forgot
mm-hmm.
on purpose.
And you're trying to survey all this stuff
yes.
through these sessions.
Yes, and so
trying
like,
to get back to that. But you'll get back to it though.
Yeah, that's what
I think that's what he's trying to tell you, is like you're gonna get
you're
total
gonna,
access anyway. But just
gonna,
try to just keep ringing the bell though.
Yeah. So yeah, that's what I just keep doing, and you know, so
remember that. The stadium and I think I remember.
Now we ended up in the stadium because we started in the stadium out there. Because I already knew
this was, yeah. Like I imagined in a certain way when I was out there.
Because
you were talking about it from you. You know what I mean? Like I wasn't really aware of it until you like telling me about it. And then that though was like for real. Like, oh, who's in the crowd? Is this one there? Is that one there?
Oh yeah, once you get there, just so you know. Yeah, but see if you tell someone in the third dimension that you're sitting in this thing and all these people are watching and paying close attention to you
right.
because you have all this fucking information that you're disseminating to these people, who's gonna believe that? But then when you get there and you go,
Well see, I saw ghosts a lot when I was younger too. I used to service with them to
But you know what I mean, though.
Oh, yeah.
Understand. So
no,
like,
yeah. I mean, it's like.
But I love that you just said that. You said that is like real. You said that was like really real. And that's what I was going to ask you next. How real was all of this stuff? Because that you're saying.
As real as like this reality would be if you saw it for what it was. You know, if you saw like all the cavities and all the translucence of it.
You said it was morphing and changing pretty constantly. Throughout the entire time.
Depend on like what layer I was looking at, because like you take a magnifying glass and you look at your hands, like you can see real good detail, but if you just bring it out, you're seeing like larger themes of color and shit like that. It was like that. I was looking at it from these different ways, and so
it took me a while to get you to really start.
Yeah, it'd be like here it is. I was like, every time you asked a question, it was like I was having a Google search for like 10,000. You know, you want to page through this, or some, and then sometimes you hit it to where it was like 5, you know. It's like, that's a good search.
So it was. I think the funny part was as I'm talking to you, I'm actually taping this part because people always think they know what's happening in the session, or they know what you're thinking or how you're feeling. And I'm not saying everyone is like that, but a lot of people every now and then get on and they're just all negative and saying all kind of crap. It's like, dude, if you only knew. I mean, because at one point I was literally here on the edge of my chair way up here in your face like, dude, what the fuck? Are you going to talk or what? And I was like, I can't believe. And you're like,
yeah. Said, I knew you were right there.
You said, calm down. And then I sat back in my chair and I grounded. I saw my tail wrap around the diamond.
Well, and then, but like, it helped you to connect with what I was experiencing.
Yes, exactly. Because
and get on my level, then you can understand it instead of being frustrated not understanding it.
Well, it wasn't that I wasn't understanding it. It was so much that it was hard for you to interpret it. Because
like,
I was like, because at one point I asked you, I was like, dude, don't you have a college degree? And I know you're super smart. You can't think
yeah,
of
we're like
adjective.
Yeah,
I said,
we haven't spoken English in any of these lives, have we?
I'm like, where's Bounty White when you need her? I'm like, can someone give him a prepositional phrase or something? It was.
And then I was like, man, you know, I just gotta start saying it like,
it took
like a poetry or something.
Yes.
Like a, and that, you know what? Now that I think about that, that's probably why all those messages come in like that, like those snapshots and those like.
Yes.
Symbols.
So, have you listened to my poems before? Mm-hmm. Okay. And it really is a, and afterwards I'm always like, oh, that's sort of cool. Or sometimes, you know, it just depends, but it just sort of hits me like a bell, like, bing, go write it. I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
And the noise is the thing that, like, you're writing out, you know? You took the noise and, or the, you know, the sound, and then you're like magnifying, like, all right, it's this word, and that word, and this word. But you, like, experience the bell. Or even like saying ring the bell versus saying like make sure you get the message out, you know?
Yeah.
It's totally different than that. That was the way that I was. And then you can reinterpret that through the years.
And sometimes, oh, I can just say, just speaking about writing those messages or whatever, sometimes it's about the big picture or whatever, or sometimes it's just about what the heaven is going on in my life, you know what I'm saying? But it's strange, the ones when I post about what's going on in my life are the ones that sometimes I get someone say, oh my God, I know exactly what you're talking about,
because right.
I'm going through that also.
Yeah.
And I'm always thinking those are the ones that people are like, oh God, here he goes talking about himself again, that they're not going to want to listen. But I always get the best messages out of those, even though the ones that's talking about, you know, what everyone is saying. Well,
yeah.
Not what everyone is saying.
Whatever, yeah, like a reflection of what you're experiencing.
Yes.
Versus writing down the reflection of you looking out or something.
I think that's really interesting now after the fact, listening to what you're saying, as far as you say, there I am walking through every room, writing everything down, and
it's like, oh, that's that guy.
Yeah, but there's so many thoughts that go through my head when I start to write, and I was like, what the hell is that all about? And I was like, okay, I'll figure it out when someone goes, oh my God, that so, and I was in my, I swear in my mind, like, maybe I just thought I had to say something, I really didn't have anything to say, although of late I have been, no matter what I write, and I don't know, I think I really do like all of my pieces. There are some times when I don't.
Man, I wrote a bunch of poetry when I was in a lot of pain in high school, and when the Blood Moon came around, and I just got like emptied out, oh my God, I went back and read all that, and it, you know, I'd read it throughout the years, randomly, and I was like, oh yeah, I kind of remember that, but then that was when I really experienced it, and was like letting it go, like crying, just as hard as when I wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
And so at different times, that same symbol can
be experienced totally different. I love the thought that when you were down and out, or in a particular not so good way, that you decide to get up and write. I've never really been, even in the worst things that have happened to me, I was trying to lift some wood.
I don't see it.
On my head.
You know? Oh, this one right here.
Okay. And that's real wood too. So
yeah.
But I say, I haven't, even in my worst, I haven't really been so down or even depressed or whatever. Only thing, like, I know when I feel like I'm in a depressive mood or whatever, and that's when I'm thinking about what's going on with the planet, or I'm feeling what horrible shit is going on with the planet, because I feel like you said, I really do feel like I'm everywhere, and so I'm very empathic, and so when I feel all these people that are suffering, and I know so wholeheartedly all the horrible things that are going on, you know, if I think about it for too much or whatever, it may put me in the mood for a couple days or whatever, and then
This was like general horror at the, because when you're in high school, you're stuck with, you're undergoing all the experience that you're going to undergo, that's all the karma re-inheritance from your family, you know, and you're stuck, you gotta face that, you're gonna face that, and that was one way for me.
Well, for me, I haven't, my bad stuff has not been like that. It's been, well, they already know. All right, guys, thank you very much for listening. I do appreciate it. Love and light. Namaste.